so he needed some inspiration, so he went for a long walk in the woods. And while he was walking, he looked up and he noticed there was this beautiful sparkling light all around him. He realized that it was the starlight. And the stars were shining off the snow-covered branches of the fir tree. And this was so beautiful to him because it reminded him of the star that shone the night the Christ child was born. And so he wanted to bring this illustration home to his family and to his congregation. So he chopped down one of the trees in the forest. So when you're walking late at night in the forest, you need to carry an axe. You never know what can happen. So he took one of the trees home. Now, kids, nobody had ever seen a Christmas tree before. Nobody ever seen that. So can you imagine what the kids thought when he dragged the tree into the house? We can imagine what the wife thought. That probably was not a great moment. But they figured out how to put it up, and then they clipped white candles to it, and they lit the candles, and then it sparkled with the beauty and the magic that he'd seen in the forest that evening. He shared that with his congregation, and we have the Christmas tree as a result. And the German Tannenbaum is so very famous. It has many songs written about it, but there's one I bet you all know. Does everyone know O Christmas Tree? Yes. Well, Jesse's going to teach us one line in German so that we'll know it in German, all right? So teach us one line in German, would you?
Okay. O Tannenbaum, wie grün sind deine Blätter.
Okay, that's tougher than hallo. That's a little harder than hallo. But we can do it. We can do it. You guys try. We'll sing it through once to really get those German words, and then we'll really go for it on the second time, all right? So let's try it.
O Tannenbaum, wie grün sind deine Blätter.
You can get it.
O Tannenbaum, wie grün sind deine Blätter.
You did a great job. That sounded so beautiful. All right. Well, my night, and Merry Christmas to you. You can try that. Well, don't clap, Mom. That means you get an extra present from St. Nicholas next year. It's a very special tradition that comes to us from my German-American heritage. Now, there's one more Germany first that I bet you all know about, recognize. Who's this?
Nutcracker.
The Nutcracker. That's right. The Nutcracker. And in German, how do you say this?
Nussknacker.
Good. Yes. Have you seen the ballet?
Yes.
Has anyone been in it? What did you play? You've been a clown in it. Oh, fantastic. It's a wonderful ballet. And it comes from a German Christmas story. Tchaikovsky was a Russian composer, but the German Christmas story is about a little girl named Clara, and she gets a nutcracker as a Christmas present, and she dreams it comes to life, and it takes her to the land of sweets where she meets it. The Sugar Plum Fairy, and I love this story. I always wanted to be Clara when I was a little girl, but I didn't catch it. So I thought what would be fun was if we could imagine, okay? So kids, come sit over here. We're all going to imagine together. Come in together, you guys. Come in together. Very good. So come over here and let's imagine. Close your eyes. I want to scooch over and close your eyes because we are going to imagine that we are in a snow-covered sleigh. Close your eyes and imagine you're in the... Yeah, close your eyes. Close your eyes and imagine that you're in a snow-covered sleigh. And imagine that there's four beautiful white horses pulling the sleigh. And you're going to the land of sweets. And there, close your eyes and imagine life-size chocolates and life-size marshmallows and big candies. And then imagine the life-size nutcracker. Can you imagine it? Well, open your eyes and see how you did. Look what you did with your good Disney magic imagination. Didn't it do a good job? Great work! You brought us a life-size nutcracker print. And we are so delighted to have shared these things with you. The nutcracker comes to us from Germany. It's to celebrate the traditions that we use to celebrate the holidays here in the United States and around the world. So on behalf of myself and Jesse, we'd like to say thank you.
Dankeschön.
And Merry Christmas and Happy New Year to you all. Frohe Weihnachten. Or as we say in Germany, Schlaf in Himmelschuhu.
Sleep in heaven.
Merry Christmas, everyone. Thank you so much. And if you would like to get a picture with the Nutcracker, Miss Penny here is the front of the line. So come get in line with Miss Penny.
Stand there and Chantel.
Go on the other side, Chantel.
Go the other side, Chantel.
You'll have to get in closer, girls. I can't get you in because I've had to come in close on the camera. Otherwise, you can't read it anyway.
Don't worry, folks. guessing whose holiday tradition we were going to use to light the tree this year.
Tradition, huh? Let's see. Oh, well, I think I forgot mine. Gosh, why don't we make our own tree lighting tradition?
A new tradition? As we sing out strong, come world Christmas song.
Up from each valley and over each hill,
a beautiful song,
peace and goodwill.
It holds us together as we sing along the around the world Christmas song.
Here's an around the world Christmas song that our friends taught us how to sing in Italian.
Come on. so much easier.
Here with the custom of Christmas trees. You happen in Canada, United States? Well, Christmas trees, the custom of Christmas trees may very well have started in Germany. But today, most of the world's Christmas trees are grown right here in
Canada.
What a good one! You're learning quickly. Very good. So, one year on my travels throughout the Canadian provences, over the snow-capped mountains of British Columbia to the west, to Newfoundland in the east, I decided I would find out for myself about these beautiful old Canadian holiday customs. He's making a list, checking it twice, going to find out who's naughty or nice. Santa Claus is coming to town. You know that song?
Yeah.
Oh, yes. Scared the pants off you when you were a kid, didn't it? I mean, after all, how does he know who's been naughty and who's been nice, huh? Well, he has his way. But in certain traditional Canadian homes, he has special help finding out who's naughty or nice. Stranger in unusual costume who come to your homes on the holidays, and they are called relatives. I'm kidding. They're called bells, Nichols. Now the story goes that if children don't behave themselves during the year, not only might they find coal in their stockings, but the devilish bells might grab them and take them away. Oh, of course, we would never allow that to happen, but I must say that Canadian children seem to be particularly good at this time of year. Now on Epiphany, that's January 6th, our friends to the north, the Inuit children, are visited by strange creatures called Nalliooks. Well, they're little light bell snickles, but Nalliooks go from house to house with sticks. And the children, they must sing carols to them. Then the Nalliooks pound their sticks on the floor, and they ask the children questions about their behavior over the past year. But if the children answer with a truthful heart, then the Nalliooks open their bags and give the boys and girls special presents. Now, speaking of special presents, my favorite present is the gift of food. Nobody seems surprised at that. Well, anyway, in Quebec, there's nothing better than that old French custom of a late night dinner on Christmas Eve after midnight mass, called Le Réveillon. Oh, you should have been there. The tortillas. Oh, I'm sorry, some of you might not know. Tortilla is kind of a savory meat pie. And then you had turkey and dressing and sweet potatoes. Oh, and from the British, plum pudding for dessert. Oh, where was I? Oh yes, the British. From the British comes that most unusual holiday just a few days ago. December 26th. Boxing Day! That's the day when all the presents you don't want are brought back to the store and all the people lined up waiting to go in, duke it out to see who goes in first. Boxing, duke it out. Stay with me, yeah? But you knew that wasn't true. Actually, what it is you have you take filled Christmas boxes or other gifts and give them to tradesmen or servants as a thank you for good service over the past year. Now this harkens back hundreds of years to England once again, where on December 26th, the churches would open their alms boxes and share their contents with those in need. So my friends, as you can see, Canada shares so many customs and traditions with so many countries and peoples that it's difficult to say if there really is a Canadian Santa Claus. Now truthfully, I've never seen him face to face. But you would do best to keep your eyes open. He might be right in front of you. You might not even know it. So my friends, I must go. Believe it or not, there's much to do before next year. So, enjoy your holidays, wherever and however you spend them. Oh, and be good. Not only do you have to answer to Papa Noel, but
which may have to answer to those Nalayaks. They can be mean little things. Merry Christmas, Joyeux Noël, and thank you for listening.
Ooh, I smell evil men. Here, pull my finger.
No! But they saw standing in the clearing a vision of a most beautiful woman. In fact, it was the evil, nasty, wicked wizard. Hello!
Ooh, the evil, nasty wizard. Pelham! Pelham! Tell me about the evil, wicked wizard. Pelham.
She was evil.
She was evil.
She was intelligent.
She was intelligent.
She was crafty.
She was Martha Stewart.
Yes. No!
Crafty. She used as a good girl.
I know. She did have the uncanny ability to transform herself from the old hag into
what?
A vision of the most beautiful woman.
Oh, the beautiful woman. Pelham.
Own the forest, baby. Yeah, own it. Yeah, go on. Yeah. Right over here. She looks over to the knights and she looks at Galahad. She says, hello.
That's not the Tim, the one with the G.
He says, I hope you don't mind. What do you say? Oh. This is not the Jerry Springer show.
But Galahad, being of pure heart and no mind, knew this wasn't a beautiful woman at all. He knew it was, in disguise, the evil, nasty wizard Pelham.
The evil! The evil!
Oh, yes. And he shunned the wizard by letting forth with his barbaric battle cry.
Oh! More like George of the Jungle.
Hey, it did scare you. In fact, it scared the witness so much she shrieked. And she fled in fear. Fear is.
The knights then galloped on, Galahad. Oh, it's all right, I'll send you back to night school. Branko, what did you think of the show so far?
Meanwhile, back at the castle, good, the King Arthur!
Long live the King!
It's great to be king! Boom, boom, boom!
Oh, you sat down on that one. Okay, sit down again. It's your castle, it's your thing. Oh, now, back to the knights. They soon found themselves in front of the castle Carmenet.
Oh, we're in front of the castle Carmenet.
Right, the castle Carmenet, where they happen to know that this was the resting place of
the Holy Grail! Grail, Grail, Grail!
Oh!
That's me, mate.
Being the bolder of the two knights.
That's me, mate.
Being the more intelligent of the two knights. Oh, very nice. That's great.
Well, guess he knows how to use the screwdriver. Andy Gregg.
He stood in front of the door. A small child ran by. No, he stood in front of the door. And he rang the bell.
Oh, he really is handy. He invented electricity.
You're right, you are smart.
He's a medieval guy, right? A big rope hanging down attached to a giant bell. Bring that one.
Well done, Quasimodo.
Not nothing!
Not a child.
For nothing! For nothing!
Something good.
nothing happens, but the knights pushed open the doors.
Push open the door. Now say bonjour. They're French doors.
Oh, please. Standing in front of them in the eerie darkness was a strange, ominous, yet familiar-looking figure.
Yes, it was the wizard Pelham, but this time in 528 hag form.
Wait, 528 hag form?
Yes. It was the upgrade from the 527.
I love the 527.
Yeah,
that was good.
528-year-old hag. She staggered down the hallway. She descended the spiral staircase. She looked over at Galahad and she said,
just move your mouth, all right?
I am the wizard Pelham, keeper of the Holy Grail. And he who meets my secret challenge shall be given the Holy Grail. And if you act now, you get a free set of skate knives. You want to hear about the bamboo steamer?
No! Now, this calls Galahad to laugh to himself. To himself. You sure that's Greg? He decided to meet the challenge, so he stepped into the ring. The crowd are going to chant his name. Galahad! Galahad!
Galahad! Galahad! Galahad! Galahad!
Then the secret challenge was revealing. The secret challenge is...
The limbo! Yes! Oh, the limbo! Can you go? Yeah!
Yeah! No, you're not all done yet. Wait, there's more. Having defeated the Mighty Wizard's mediocre challenge...
Medieval
challenge, sorry, love.
The Holy Grail! 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 Grail!
The wizard presented the cup to Galahad with a hop, a skip, and a jibber. Ready, go. Hop, skip, jibber.
I missed the jibber.
Jibber. Jibber. Jibber. Give a jibber. Right, all right, lady.
What the jibber was.
I don't know. And she staggered back over here.
Yes, she's talking
about it. And he laughed to himself. Ah! He got back on his horse. Which is just a wee Shetland pony now. Nevertheless, he rode back to Camelot boldly.
It's over here, mate. You got a fast pass.
First one today. Here you go, look. Once back to Camelot with a great sense of awe.
Oh.
He presents the cup to the king. Present the cup to the king. The king looked deep within the cup. The king looked deep within the cup. He saw the most sublime of all the universal mysteries answered for him. Do you see it, Your Majesty? He looked up from the cup and he said, ooh, ooh. He said, ah.
He was so amazed, he said, yeah. I got me a cup, bring the dog, he's eating it, but the beans are mum. Bam, 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 a boom, bam, baby, yeah.
Thank you. in Camelot, you can see it here. The King was happy.
All fair to me.
It's great to be king. Boom, boom,
boom. The wizard being relieved of her burden, her 527, her 528, whatever it works. She was happy. Yes. And of course, the Galahad was truly happy. Yes. In fact, all of us here in Camelot were
happy.
We were Gladys Knights. Ladies and gentlemen, that's our show. What did you think of it?
Right!
How about a hand for the real stars?
Mary Poppins, Julie Andrews.
That's not really her.
Do you think?
Batteries a bit. You got yours. You've done it on yours.
Yeah, that's fine.
Thank you. Thank you. Good day.
I won't know how to show.
Sky blue, sky blue, sea green, 7 and then 7:55, that's the one that everybody remembers so clearly, 7:55 this evening. And each show is different, all songs are different. And after this last number, we'll come down there and say hello, so don't be shy, come by and see us. We hope everybody's enjoying themselves here today. We're going to ask you right now, because we see that you're singing along, you know the words, I mean, obviously you do. So help us out on a bit of a high note. Try this, just try it as loud as you can, all of you now, not just a couple of you, all of you. Thank you.
Canada we've done, UK we've done, we're in France, there's only Morocco, Japan, America, and Italy.
What country are you in at the moment?
More to do. Them four.
What country are you in at the moment, Shanta?
Discovery Cove.
No.
France.
France, that's right.
France.
Morocco, Japan, America, and Italy to do now, anyway. Yeah, that's fine. Thank you.
We're going to stop babbling all the time. Would you like to be in there? I'd like to take it for you.
Moving from France into Morocco. We're zooming around the world in record time. Oh look, in the sky.
Oh look what it says up in G-O-L.
They're still writing it. It's probably going to be God. Probably some religious program.
Oh yeah. G-O-D.
Getting together, some of
them don't have kids.
Your sister. soccer than blue. See, the heater right on you. As you guys are little, you're going to have mouth fights. And once you get older, you guys are going to be each other's bag, like peanut butter and jelly. Yes. Or peanut butter and banana, depending on what, you know, what you like. Or peanut butter and honey. Or peanut butter and honey. Or mayonnaise and honey. You're going to go together like that.
Lovely. Okay. Good question.
Hello. The red light's flashing.
Low on tape.
Straighten it, Dev?
I would think so.